Greetings, comrades. There are some holders of the Zimbabwe exemption permits that were given a V-list. You know that if you are given a V-list, it makes it difficult for you to travel. You might have been given a V-list because when you were waiting either for the outcome of your DZP or ZSP or ZEP, you were then given a V-list, or you lost your passport that had a permit, and then you were given a V-list. We are here to try and assist you so that you do not face these challenges that make it easy for you to travel. We are currently trying to assist only those that are holders of a ZEP. So if you are a holder of a ZEP, just contact us, send me an email, send your documents. You might have been given a letter at the port of entry or at the airport. Send that letter on email. Send the copy of your passport. Send the proof that you are on ZEP. If you have applied for your waiver, or if you have a receipt, or applied for any of the visas, be it a spouse visa, a general work visa, please send those as well. Send the copy of your passport. Send the copy of the stamp where there's this V list. Kindly email to ngabuthomabena@gmail.com. ngabuthomabena@gmail.com. I know that some you are unable to spell the name Ngabutho. So the name, the email address is on this video. So we want to assist such individuals. Then the last thing is that if you are in South Africa, you are undocumented, and the school insisted that you should get a study visa for your kids, it is difficult for you to apply for the study visa for your kids if yourself you are not documented. So it's important that the parent of the child must be documented before you can apply for the visa of your child, because it makes it difficult for you to apply for the visa, for the child study visa, if your child, if yourself as a parent, you are not documented. I said the last, but also there's this question. We recorded a video where we said those that are working as domestic workers should be granted special permits. We never said you can get a permit if you have worked for 5 years. There was a misunderstanding on that. We are doing advocacy work. So advocacy work is different from a decision that has been taken. So what you are simply doing is that you should be considered, if you are working as a domestic worker, as we're talking in the video, that you should be granted. So I want to say there is no decision. So you cannot apply for a domestic for a permit on the basis that you are a domestic worker, you have worked for 5 years. We are doing advocacy work around this question. Thank you so much. Please like this video, subscribe to this YouTube channel. If you are on YouTube, if you are on TikTok, please do follow us. We're in Pretoria. Tswane is becoming hot. Thank you so much.